Checking the futures now, they've lost a little bit of gas. Again, we had a very disappointing job number, less than half of what we were expecting. At first, the market took that as good news. Perhaps that would lead to a softening of the comments of Chairman Powell earlier in the week when he suggested he was going to speed up tapering. Markets like it when the interest rates stay low and there's more tapering. But in fact, it looks like it's about where it was before. The Dow Jones Industrial is up 106 right now. Let's bring in David Nicholas. David, what's your reaction to the jobs number?
Hey, good morning, David. It was somewhat of a confusing report. I mean, you had the household survey that showed some gains, but then you had the payroll survey that really showed a decline in job growth. So certainly I was disappointed with the number that I saw. I mean, you could have a positive spin on it. Labor force participation grew by 600,000. That's always a good thing if those are going back into the labor force. But really bad news for retail. I mean, normally we see a lot of seasonal hiring for retail going into the end of the year. We didn't see that. So I think hospitality
really
issues.
Got it on the chin. Do you think that was it was a little too early for Omicron? We didn't even hear about Omicron until after the figures were closed. So could it be something other than the pandemic, the real weakness in hospitality?
Yeah, I think there's some of that, but there's still this uncertainty about the virus. I think more and more individuals, as we get into 2022, are going to get more comfortable with going out. But I think some of this is virus related, but I was surprised by it. When I look at ticket prices, when I look at travel, when I look at retail and restaurants, hospitality seems to be on fire. So a little confusing. I think this may be more of a they can't find the right people. And I think that is a problem that is plaguing a lot of industries, not just hospitality. And I think that's why we're not seeing.
How about the automotive industry? We're always talking about chips, but what about them in terms of hiring for the assembly line?
Yeah, David, we've been really bullish on Ford. Ford's had a great year, up over 120% year to date. But as good as Ford has done, they're still struggling to get the parts and supplies that they need. So I think the automotive sector as a whole is good because the demand is robust. But they are losing sales because they are parking cars in parking lots because they can't get the chips.
Well, Ford came out with the announcement they're going to be ginning up their research and their work on making chips themselves. Is that any sign of progress there?
Yeah, very, very bullish. But, the chips is one part of it. Building a vehicle is so intricate, so many details. I was having a conversation with a car manufacturer, and they're saying, down to the piping, down to the tires, there's so much that they need to get these automobiles to market. Yeah. So it's a good first step, but there's still going to be a lot more to get the supplies that they need.
But we love their pickup truck, 45 years, number one spot. Meanwhile,